Leader Gallagher, we got the Democratic take on this. Want to get the Republican side now from you. You are staunchly opposed to this. That might be an understatement. I follow you on X, formerly known as Twitter, and I believe you said you're ready to light this up. So make the case to our viewers statewide. Why is this special session, in your opinion, a bad idea?
Well, one of them is being pushed by the governor to one policy, supposedly, and this policy would actually lead to higher gas prices. So if we were going to have a special session to talk about the need to do something about fuel prices in this state, absolutely, I think we should do that. But when the only policy you seem to be considering is one that will force shortages and that will raise our gas prices, it's a terrible idea. And we should be talking about other things. Now, look, we're going to use this opportunity as Republicans to talk about the things that would actually lower people's prices. So we are going to be talking about, hey, let's repeal or cut back the gas tax. That would provide people immediate relief right now. We would talk about the cap and trade system and how fuels are part of that system in ways that don't make sense and would actually, if we took them out, we could actually lower gas prices for everyone immediately. These are things that we should be talking about that would provide the consumer immediate relief. And unfortunately, the Democrats seem to be very hesitant or refuse to talk about these things.
Okay, so you talk about repealing the gas tax, and this is something you and your Republican colleagues have been talking about since it was passed. And it's just, it's a non-starter. So is bringing that up essentially a waste of time?
I don't think that our consumers think it's a non-starter. They think that they're paying too much at the gas pump already. And the bottom line is it's the easiest way to reduce our costs at the pump right away. And so we can do things to deal with the road revenues. We can actually backfill that with general fund money. I think most people would think that our roads and infrastructure are a priority. It's certainly something that we could do. It's not impossible. It just requires the will to do it.
All right. So I'm wondering if you could weigh in on the consensus on this in terms of not just Republicans, but Democrats in the building, because it seems like neither chamber was on the same page, and obviously not on the same page with the governor. The assembly got there quicker, and we learned late Thursday that the Senate's there in a way only if something is passed out of your chamber. But, I mean, even though you're on the Republican side, you guys all talk. Can you give us a little bit of a take of how Democrats are feeling about this? Because they'll tell you, you know, behind the scenes or off the record one thing, but, you know, when we're talking on TV here, they might say something different.
Yeah, I have not understood why the Democratic leadership in both houses seem to bend over backwards, you know, for this governor, and in ways that actually make them look really bad. I mean, and the most recent example was Prop 36, when they tried to do these poison pills at his behest, and then they tried to explain that to the media, and they had no excuse for why they were doing this. They could not explain how. You know, those bills conflicted with the repeal of Prop 47. Now, you know, they've gotten pushed into this special session when I think they obviously both really didn't want to do it. And yeah, I think there is a lot of, you know, disgruntlement amongst Democratic members because they keep seeing, you know, placation of the governor in ways that put them in a bad spot.
Okay, so you are in the minority. I don't have to tell you that, but I want to kind of zoom out and do a 30,000 foot view, because you're swimming upstream every day when you're in the building. And what's the strategy for the Republican Party? Because obviously, representative democracy is alive and well here in the state of California. Democrats are elected because the folks in their districts pick them to send them here to the state capitol. The same for Republicans in the respective districts. So, what's the strategy in terms of messaging? Because polling has shown that people do feel like the state is going in the wrong direction and that prices are high, but it doesn't seem like it's, you know, trickling down in terms of these state races in the state house.
We see a huge opportunity, and we've been playing out the strategy. We've been playing it out for 2 years now. And what it is just talking to the heart of where people are at in California. And number one, everybody's got their head in hands trying to figure out how to pay all the bills in California. We've been talking to them directly about how we want to cut those costs. And not just your gas prices, but your utility bills? How do we solve the insurance crisis in this state that is plaguing far too many households? So we've been talking about those real nut and bolt issues that everybody's concerned about, those kitchen table issues. And we see that it's paying off. I mean, in the polls, we're seeing that people want a new direction. And I will tell you, in a recent race that we were looking at, 31% of people who had never voted Republican are looking Republican time. We think the message is working. We think that California is ready for change. And let's just be frank, the Democratic supermajority has failed California. It failed them on crime. It's out of control. It's failed on home. Millions spent with no results.
Does the national message, do you think that hurts your efforts here in California as a Republican? What's happening nationally, specifically Donald Trump?
No, because I think that same thing is going on nationally, and everybody else can look and say, hey, 4 years ago under Donald Trump, I was doing so much better. You know, the Biden, you know, Kamala Harris has the same problem. She's part of a failed administration that has essentially gotten nothing done for the American people. And now Gavin Newsom is the head of a failed California administration that has failed on every front. I mean, they can point to not one issue that they've made progress on. They spent billions of our dollars only to make our problems worse. And so I think people get that. We're seeing it in the polling. And I think it's a great opportunity for Republicans. Now, we've been talking about real solutions, and I think that's what really helps us, is we're talking about what we would do to cut your costs. We have actual bills. We have actual legislation that would actually cut your gas prices, you know? And I think people are seeing that, and they're seeing that the Democrats don't have answers for the very real struggles they face.
All right, we will leave it there. Leader Gallagher, we appreciate your time here always on Inside California Politics.
Likewise. Good to be with you.